Thank you. Lord. Amen po? Amen. I believe we are all excited to praise the Lord. And sa mga nandun po sa ating lobby, wow, lobby. Can I request everyone to come inside in the sanctuary as we're going to lift the name of Jesus here in this place. Amen po. And may I request everyone to please all stand, and all our viewers all over the world, wherever you are so welcome here. And we invite you to come along with us, sing with us, and be with us for this moment as we're going to celebrate God's goodness and faithfulness sa ating mga buhay. Amen po ba? Amen. Are we excited? Church! Wow! Woo! Thank you, thank you. Praise God. So come on, let's acknowledge the presence of the Lord here in this place and in every rooms right now. Hallelujah, Jesus. We thank you, Father, for this amazing moment, this amazing afternoon that you have given to us. Lord, here we are, oh God, gathered with our brothers and sisters, oh God, that it says in your word that two or three gathered in your name, you are in our midst, oh God. It's not by the quantity, but it's the quality, oh God. Lord, see every hearts right now. Search our hearts, the every motives of our hearts, oh God, why we are coming. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, see every posture of our hearts, oh God, if it is aligned according to your will, O Lord, that the very reason why we are seeing this live, why we are coming here to church, it is because of you, Jesus. Nothing else. Oh God, we just, the reason why that we are here, O Lord, is to go back and be reminded of how good you are, how faithful you are sa aming mga buhay. Lord, we're not coming after the blessings. We're not coming after of what we are going to receive. But Lord, we're coming and we're here. We're believing, oh God, to see your face once again, oh God. Lord, right now, let there be open heavens. Let your face shine among us, oh God. Hallelujah, Jesus. Saturate every corners of this church, of this building, and saturate every hearts right now to be expectant of your presence. Because no other place, no other safest place here on earth, oh God, but only in your presence. Lord, thank you, Jesus, for everything that you are going to do at this moment and on, oh God. That you will be the center, that you will be glorified, oh God, for this is the day that you have made, and we will rejoice, oh God, and be glad in it. Lord, thank you for all the things that you have done, for all the things that you did, and for all the things that you're going to do in our lives, oh God. We just want to celebrate this day and give this day the best for you, oh God. Nothing else and no one else will be lifted high but you alone. We thank you, Father, for all the things, oh God. We give you back all the glory, the honor, the adoration to you alone in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Amen, amen. Can we give the best clap offering to the Lord? Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise Jesus. Come on, let's worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Amen, hallelujah. Come on. Oh are so expectant, Father. Come on, church. Just continue to open your hearts to God right now. He is done. He is not done with you yet. holy name, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, for your amazing love, for unending mercy and grace to each one, oh God. Lord, empty our fullness and fill the emptiness of our hearts, oh God. Lord, we are so ready to see what you wanted us to see and to do whatever you wanted us to do, oh God. Lord, to you all the glory, the honor, and the praises. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name.
To God. Napakasarap magpuri at narito tayo ngayon sa ating place to worship our God, and those nasa online, maraming salamat po at nariyan din po kayo at taus-pusong nakikinig. And andito po tayo sa ano, makisuyo po ako sa ano, sa kung pwede pa kita po ito sa ating tithes and offering. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 13 po. Ayan. Ang nakalagay po eh, and now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Parang when I read yung verse na to, and nasabi ni Pastora na ikaw mag-aano ng tithes and offering, and then I come to think, what is the reason why we are here and why we are online listening to our God? And why is the reason why God came to us to save us? And the only reason, I think, is love. Amen. The greatest daw is love. Even yung sa, when we have a relationship, person to person, we put effort, diba? We show effort because we love the person. And here we are, we came here, na instead of nakiki-jump tayo sa ating mga kaibigan, or nakikiparty tayo, or nagfi-fishing tayo, or magandang weather, nasa park tayo. But here we are, nandito tayo to give worship. And those who are online, instead na natutulog tayo, naka-tune in kayo to hear the word of God. And before this, yung verses na to, mapapansin ninyo, quick lang, ang sabi dito yung sa 1 Corinthians chapter 13 verse 1, if I speak in tongues of men or of angel, but do not have love, I am only a surrounding gong or clanging cymbal. If the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have faith that can move mountains, but not have love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and give over my body to hardship, and that I may boast, but I do not have love, I gain nothing. So, nasabi ko, I was thinking to myself, if sabi, if I am here without the love to our God, then what's the point I am alive? What's the point of having a family kung if our God is not within me? You know, the important thing is love to our God. Because of love, you can do everything. Because of love, you can move mountains. Nothing is impossible. You can give, but if without love, it's nothing. Now I'm standing here. Without God's love, I am nothing too. I am nothing too. I just want to share. I think this was also mentioned by Pastor when we were in Dubai. There's a story of a father and a daughter. Okay? The daughter asks the father, "Father, how much you earn per hour?" I don't know exactly how much the hourly rate of the father, but let's say $25 per hour. And the daughter said, "Can I borrow $10? Okay? The father said, "Why? Why you need the $10? "Because I have here 40 with me. I can pay you 2 hours just to have time with me." "Time for what?" The father's asked. "Time for me to play with me, to eat with me, and to bonding with me." That's the definition of love of the daughter to his father. But the father's love, he was only thinking as a provider. That is the definition of the father to his family, as a provider. But the daughter's definition of love is to have time with his father. Same with us here. We want to have time to our God. We are here to have time, and we are here to give thanks, and we are here to give back what belongs to him. Amen. So, to cut the story short, the father was embarrassed, you know. The child, his child, his own child wants to pay his time because of love. You know, so we are grateful, you know. We are able to come here. We are able to finish the whole week because of God. Because of God, we are here. And because of God, we are able to conquer whatever the circumstances we have faced. Because we know God works behind the scene. Then that is how God you know, save us every day. You know, he gave his only son, he gave his only life. That's how our God loves us so much. And then this tithes and offering, God is telling us, just give me. Just this money, does he doesn't want it, but he wants us to obey. Why? Because so many souls we can bring and worship to have a relationship with him. Not because of money, but because we want to share the love of Jesus Christ to others. That's the reason why. God doesn't want the money, but he wants us to be obedient so that we can reach so many souls, so that in our own time, there will be an eternal love with him. Eternal love. Eternal love means we will be with him forever. So the material that we have, we honored our God to everything that we have. Our finances, we want to give it to God. We want God to share it with him. Because we came here, our body physically, but we don't want, "Lord, I will remove my wallet and keep it at home. Only my body, but not including my wallet." But God is the one who gave us our work. You know, we want our God to be involved in our finances, you know. So I encourage you to give this because you love God, not because you are forced to do it. I want you because of love. You are giving this to our God. So let us raise the envelope. And for those who are online, you will find out the details there, how you can give. And if you want, you have a prayer request, send us the prayer request. Okay, let's bow down and have our prayer. Our prayer, Lord, we humble ourselves to you by giving our love in our financial aspect. This is a symbol that with you, God, we are nothing. Because of your great love to us, you gave us your only son, your only life to us. Please accept this as a sweet aroma to show we love you. Bless us, Lord, more so that we can bless others too. For those who seek job and desire to give, Lord, bless them because we have faith in you that you are our God that provides all our need. Thank you, Lord, for this day, the presence that we have, the gift that we receive daily from you and about to receive. Reach our dear loved ones wherever they are right now. We are also praying for the gospel today, the word that we will listen and we will receive from you, that this word will magnify to our lives. Lord, anoint our Pastor John and bless his family to keep them safe always. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Thank you po.
Thank you so much. We declare to all of our Lord giver this afternoon and for those who are supporters of this church, bless them with the blessing of heaven and earth and bless them with the blessing of Abraham to them and to their families. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Praise God. So may we call on our kids. Let us also pray for our kids. Amen. Kids are 12 years old below. How old are you? 13? Okay, come here. We want to pray for you. Sit down. Okay. Come on, Ashong. Amor is coming. Okay. Hallelujah. Come on down. Amen. You know, it's this prayer is more than candy. Huh? This prayer is more than surprises. Okay, so all are present now. Let's extend our hands once again to these kids. Thank you, God, for giving us, Lord, this heritage. They are the next generation, our posterity. They are, Lord, your gift to us. And thank you so much for giving us, Lord, a wonderful opportunity to bring this up, these children, in the knowledge of the Lord. And use the parents, Lord, to raise these people, these kids, and be, Lord, we declare that the wisdom of God be upon them. And they will be wiser than their teachers, their instructors. Thank you so much. and bless them. Let your angels be with them 24/7, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Lord, you will guard them, guide them, protect them from accident and from sickness and disease. Lord, we cancel all the plans of the evil one over their lives. Even, Lord, the infectious diseases, Lord, will not enter their physical body. Thank you, God, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Praise God. So we have children's ministry. Okay. So, good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Will you please nod to your seatmates? Nod, good afternoon. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Okay. Are you okay there? Yeah. Praise God. Are you okay there? Hallelujah. So, a lot of people are coming here. Amen? I pray and I do believe in my heart that this month is a month of signs and wonders and breakthroughs and more souls to come here in this place. Okay, let us pray that, you know, God will destroy this another, what's that? Variant? Okay? Delta variant. Okay? Let's pray that everything will not continue and it will not enter here in this country. Although there are already reports that some cases are Delta, but let us pray that God will destroy that so that this opening will not be postponed, because we are now approaching mayroon bang stage 4? Is there any stage 4? Or it's, no, stage 4. Stage 3? Is the opening of gyms, etc., di ba? No, it's more open. So, stage 4, I think, is the already grand opening of the province or of the country. So let's pray, no, that this Delta virus will disseminate, will be destroyed, and will not continue. Amen. Hallelujah! Praise God. Ah, by the way, there is already another virus. In the Philippines, they call it Bilsa 30. You know Bilsa 30? You know Bilsa 30? During the 30th, there's a bill, okay? So that's a virus. It's just a joke, okay? Bilsa 30. It's not COVID-19, Bilsa 30. Okay, your dewa, and dewa tuloy, parang Dubai, ano? All your bills, okay, will be paid on the 38th. And that's a virus for everyone, especially for husband and wife. But here in this church, it was already vaccinated. Amen. We're already vaccinated for that Bilsa 30 because we are blessed. Tell to your neighbor, you are blessed. Will you please tell that to 3 people? You are blessed. You are blessed. Kitang-kita naman sa katawan eh, no? Blessed na blessed sa katawan palang pastor. Okay? Praise God. So today, I'm going to share a new August series. Amen. So I'm excited to share this. It was already long in my heart. This message is already, 7 years in my heart. And I want to share to you a series called Vision. Okay? So today, I'm going to explain to you the meaning of vision and how does vision revolutionize our lives and what vision can do to your life, to your personal life. Okay? And also for our church. Because our church is already doing the vision. For your information, our church is doing the vision of the Lord Jesus Christ, which is, okay, to win souls and to make disciples, making all the members of this church leaders. And not only leaders, but leader of leaders. Okay, so we are, this coming September, hope that it will, you know, be successful. We will have our first live class. We are doing that before, but because of pandemic, we postponed it, but we will continue it this coming September. And our mission, the mission of our church is loving God and loving people. The reason why the cross of the Lord Jesus Christ is horizontal and vertical, it is because vertical means loving God. Horizontal means loving people. Okay? Have you seen the... there's a lot of religion that says the cross of the Lord Jesus Christ is like this. Have you seen? Now, may isang pole lang na ganyan. One pole only. And he was crucified like this. Diba? Have you seen that? There's another religion that teaches that Jesus Christ, no, is just crucified, but actually not crucified. The fact that he's crucified, it means cross. Diba? Cross. Amen? So, the correct cross is like that. Horizontal and vertical. It means loving God and loving people. So that's our mission. The mission of our church is to love God, to love the people. And, you know, the vision of our church is to make all members a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ and eventually leaders and then leader of leaders. So I can see to all of you here that are attending the church, you are a leader. Tell to your neighbor, you are a leader. No, sa Tagalog, leader ka ng ano, pastor? Yun lang, ano, kapag leader ng kalukuhan. No? You are a leader. Amen? Tagapanguna ka. You are a leader of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Why? Because you are leading other people through your life. Amen. When they see you, they will see God. When they smell you, they will smell God. Wow, amoy Diyos. You smell like God. Amen? Amen? How many of you here wants to be smell like God? Pastor, he smell like smoke. He came from hell. No? Praise God. But we smell like God. Amen? We look like God because God created us. Diba? Our, what's that? Our topic called glory. Amen? God is restoring this image in us. So we look like God. So people are going to church not because of the pastor. Wow. Sana nga, no? People are going to church because of you. Oh, although I can invite people here, but, you know, if I'm only the one who will invite people, so I will be, you know, I will have no time in preparing messages. But praise God because I'm preaching to you, I'm leading you. To be what? To be an influencer. Amen. Tell to your neighbor, you are an influencer. Ano na namang influensya yan, pastor? Influensya ng kalokohan. Okay. Ng kabutihan. You are an influencer of good and God. Amen? You influence other people to God. Praise the Lord. So, what is this vision? Okay, before I continue, I want to show you some pictures here. Okay, look at the first picture. What can you see? Malabo ba? Who is looking here at two people with guitar? One is serenading and one is listening to the music. Can you see that? Or who can see here? Two old people, okay? Man and a woman. Old man, kalbo, ayan o, kalbo, at saka babaeng matanda na. No? Amen. Sino dito nakita niya? Nakita niyo ba yung nangaharana dyan? Have you seen the serenading person? Can you see the lady who is listening to the serenade? Oh, wow, it depends upon your perspective, right? So kung ano nakikita mo, what can you see here depends upon how you see Okay, the picture. Now, I'll give you more difficult picture. Okay? Pahirap to ng pahirap, ha? Ang mga kahula rito, I'll give $5. Okay, next picture. Dali lang to eh. What can you see here in this picture? Brain? How about fingers? Can you see fingers here? Yeah, some can see fingers, some can see brain. And some realizes that your brain has fingers. Diba? Diba? So it depends upon how you see the picture. Maybe you are saying to yourself, wow, my brain has fingers. It means I can move, I can do a lot of things. Hallelujah. Different interpretation. Next picture. Next picture. Ah, what can you see here in this picture? Huh? How many of you here can see rabbit? Ah, you cannot see rabbit. How about duck? Have you seen duck here? Amen. Have you seen the picture of Pastor John? It's just at the back of this picture, okay? So, last picture. Okay, ito medyo mahirap. This is a little bit difficult. Okay, what can you see in this picture? Woman, of course, that's a woman, obviously. But what kind of woman? Okay, Brother Kerwin saw which? Why? Because the baba, no? Tapos yung ilong malaki. The nose is very big, okay? But some here saw a young lady. Inside view, di ba? Can you see the hair? The hair is black, okay? And the face, the nose of the old lady is the face of the young lady. Man, and the young lady is side views. Di ba? Di ba yung isang mga ganun? I want to show you a lot of pictures actually, but these are just the pictures that I have prepared. But, you know, the truth is, this is all about vision. Vision. Amen. To be able for us to understand vision or the way you look at things. Amen? The way you look at things. Vision. Proverbs chapter 29, verse 18. I will read from King James Version. We will have at least four translations here. Now, to be able to understand. 5 translations. First, let's go to the Old King James translation. This is the oldest translation, and this is the authorized translation. So if there's any confusion in reading the Bible for you, amen, so that you will not be confused, go to the Old King James Version. But if you cannot understand Old King James Version because it's too deep, the wordings here are too deep. Sometimes you can read thou, thine, and wilt. Those words are very hard to comprehend. No, and all the wordings there are all English language. But that is the authorized. So King James Version is, in Proverbs 29 verse 18 says, where there is no, let us read, 1, 2, 3, go. When there is no vision, the people perish. But he that keepeth the law, happy is he. Where there is no vision, where there is no vision, people perish. So it says here that if when there is no vision or the ability to see things clearly or the ability to see things in God's perspective. Amen? Now I want you to write all these verses, okay? Or whatever you receive in this message, I want you to write it down so that you will not forget it. Amen? Bring out your cell phone. If you have notes there, you can put on or you can have a picture. It's okay. So that you will not forget. Because after this message, you will go to that door. You will go out from that door. And then you umpug your head. You hit your head in the door. You forget everything. So that's a big problem. Why? Because here, we should remember. We should remember, in times of testing, in times of trials, in times of, you know, hardships, balikan mo lang ito, just go back to your notes and refresh your memories of all the things that the Lord taught us. So, I'm just an instrument here. God is just using me. Now, let's go to another translation. Okay, what do you mean by people perish? Go back nga dun sa verse na yun. People perish. You know, perish, the word perish is, in Tagalog, nabubulok. No? If there's a perishable goods, it means that will not last. It will perish. So a person's life will perish if there's no vision. That's how important it is. Okay, next translation, where there is no revelation. So the word vision is translated here in this New International Version as revelation. Revelation. Okay, I have taught that to you, right? Here, I think 2 weeks ago or 3 weeks ago, it's all about revelation. So revelation means vision. Yung kapahayagan, yung ipinahayag ng Diyos sa iyo, what God told you. So people cast off restraint. If there's no vision, in King James, people perish. But here, people cast off restraint. What is cast off restraint? Restraint means self-control or discipline. So if you don't have vision or you don't have revelation from God, you don't have self-control. You don't have self-discipline. What do you mean by that? It means that anything you want to do, you will do. You don't have any, restraint in yourself. Eh, itong gusto kong gawin eh. This is what I want to do with my life. You don't have pake. No? What's that in English? You don't have pake. None of your business. This is what I want. This is what I like. No, I am a man. I want to be a lady. That's wala ka na. That's none of your business. Amen. I want to drive with in a bike without any clothing in downtown Toronto. This is my life. Diba? Have you seen that? There's a, di ba? Mayroong ganyan, di ba? Anong tawag doon? What's that? In Toronto? Ha? Huh? Oh, yun. Oh, naked gun. Naked gun ba yung tawag doon? So they are riding the bike with naked, di ba? We cannot do anything about them. Why? Because that's their life. Why? Because there's no vision. That's the truth. Sometimes truth hurts. Amen. I want to drink liquor. I want to smoke. I want to use drugs. None of your business. This is my life. But actually, the reason why you are saying to them, don't do it, it is because that's for their own good. But they cannot see that is for their own good. The reason why they're doing that is because they don't have vision. People cast off restraint. But blessed is the one who heeds wisdom's instruction. Okay, next translation. From New Living Translation. Okay. It's the same, the same verse. When people do not accept divine guidance. So here, vision is accepting divine guidance. Amen? When people do not accept divine guidance, they run wild. Have you seen people who are wild? Like lion, wild animals. You know, in the church, there's a lot of people that are wild. Not here. Maybe on the other church. Amen? They run wild. They don't have control. They don't have any control. And the pastor is kalbo already. Bald. Why? Because the pastor is having a hard time to discipline the people in the church. They're not following. They're not obeying. They're not submitting. So the pastor is always scratching his head until he became bald. They run wild. Okay? But whoever obeys the law is joyful. You know, if there's a vision in the church, people in the church, if they catch this vision, they will be what? Most blessed. Amen? Amen? And not only that, but they are joyful. Sino dito? Who wants here to be joyful all the time? Masaya ka parati. Why? Because you have vision. Okay. Message. Message. Okay? Message means monosodium glutamate. You know that mono... Bechen yun, bechen. Okay. Message is, you know, a lot of words from the original translation. Why? Because it makes it tastier, diba? Like bechen. Amen? Message. If people cannot see what God is doing, so vision is all about seeing what God is doing. They stumble all over themselves. Have you seen a person stumble? Yung napatid, natumba, na bumaliktad. Amen? A lot of people are being stumbled to other people, to themselves, right? Amen? They are easily discouraged. They are easily, people who are easily giving up in their dreams. Diba? If they encounter problems, encounter hindrances to their dreams, they will what? Quit. Why? Because they don't have vision. They cannot see a larger picture. Amen. Amen. Can you see a larger picture? Do you have a different perspective in life? The Bible said you must have this vision. Okay, last New Living Translation. Meron pa ba? Tapos na? Yeah. I've already told you. Okay. Now, next slide. Look at this next slide. Next slide, please. Yon. Vision is the dream of God for your life. Amen. Do you have a dream? Martin Luther King Jr. said, "I have a dream." You know that person? He is the first who dreamed that black and white will have harmony in America. Because during his time, there are a lot of abuses against black people. And he has a dream. Martin Luther King Jr., by the way, is a pastor. And he fought this kind of, what do you call that? Discrimination and bullying of white people to the black people. If there's a black people, black lady who is sitting down, if she saw some white person or white gentleman, she needs to give that seat to the white gentleman. No? Why? Because she is black. So, you know, he fought. Martin Luther King Jr. fought that there should be equality. Black and white should live in harmony. Praise God. That dream became a reality. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. So America right now, but here in Canada, I think we are all equal. Hallelujah. Black, brown, white, yellow, pale, whatever color you have. We are all equal here. Amen. Praise God for that privilege. Amen? Amen. But in America, until now, black matter lives. What was that? Black lives matter pala. Why? They're still fighting for it until now. Praise God for this country. Amen. It's already settled long before. Okay, vision is the dream of God for your life. God has a dream for you. Tell to your neighbor, God has a dream for you. Amen? So, you should also dream for yourself. Amen. And if you dream for something, amen, make sure that that is the dream of God for you. If you have your own vision, make sure that that vision is connected to the vision of God for you. So in order for you to really get and be caught by this vision, you need to connect it to God. You need to connect to God. You need to have a personal relationship with God to get this vision. Why? Because if you have a dream and it's not connected with God's dream for you, it's called ambition. Pastor, I have a vision. What's your vision? I want to have a car, and I want to have a big house somewhere in Bonn. Wow, Bonn. Bon petit. I mean, I want to have a swimming pool in the house. Wow. And I will earn 20,000 CAD every month. I will have a big business. And I will swim in the swimming pool full of money. That's my vision. That's not a vision. That's your own dream. And that is called ambition. Hello? So if you connect your dream to the dream of God for you, it is far greater than your personal ambition. It's far greater than your personal aspirations. It's far greater than your personal goals in life. Amen. This is not about your goals. I know you have goals in life. I know you have dreams for yourself, for your family. I know you have, it's not bad to have your own goals, your own dreams, your own vision for your life, for your family. But God wants you to have a higher goal, a higher vision, a higher purpose in life. Have you seen these people? They have a lot of money, and yet they are still lonely. That will not make you happy. A lot of money will not make you happy. A lot of material things will not make you happy. Who's that founder of Alibaba? Ma, right? Jack Ma, no? Jack Ma Awatan. You know that Jack Ma? Jack Ma is the founder of Alibaba. And although he's already a rich guy, but still, his life is empty. He admitted that in one of his, I think, podcasts or what. He spoke in a TED, you know, TED Talk. Have you, nakikinig ba kayo ng mga TED Talks? Makinig kayo one time. Amen. Because these people are all rich, but when they reach their goals, their personal goals and personal dreams of their lives, they are lonely. And they are like dissatisfied. True satisfaction is when you fulfill the dream of God for your life. Woo. Amen. Amen. God has a dream for you, and that is called vision. Okay, next slide. Next slide, please. A man, okay, the most pathetic, look at this quotation by Helen Keller. Helen Keller, please. Yeah, the most pathetic person in the world is someone who has sight but has no vision. What do you mean, Pastor, by pathetic? Yung pinakakawawa. The most miserable person in this world is having sight but no vision. By the way, Helen Keller, the author of this quotation, is a blind person. And he is also a deaf person. He used to communicate, of course, by speaking, but most of the time by using Braille. But she was an author. She was also, you know, an inspirational speaker. And he or she influenced a lot of people because even though she has this incapacity in life, and yet God still used her. His name is Helen Keller, and he said, the most pathetic person is having a sight but no vision. Because sight, listen, sight is the function of the eyes, but vision is the function of the heart. Take note of that. Ang ganda nun. Sight is the function of eyes, what you see, but vision is the function of your heart, what you see in your heart. Amen. Amen. Now, to further understand this, let's continue. Let's continue. A man without a vision is a man without a future. If you don't have a vision in life, although you have a dream, you have your own goals in life, but in God's sight, you don't have a future. You don't have a great future. You don't have an expected end. What's that expected end? A bright future. The Bible said, "For I know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you, not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a bright future." So God has a dream. God has a plan. God has a lot of thoughts about you, about me. And His thoughts about me and His plans about me is to give you a brighter future. And how to have a bright future? You need to first be caught by this vision. You need to have a vision of your life. Amen? Amen. The greatest gift, sundan niyo po ako ha, greatest gift that human receive from God is the gift of vision, not sight. The gift of vision, it's the greatest gift that God can give to you. As Helen Keller, even though she is blind, she wrote a lot of books. Why? Because she has vision. Amen. Sometimes, you know, the reason why a person is wicked or bad, it's because he has seen a lot of bad things. Because this eyes is the window of anything and it can enter into your heart. Amen. You need to really choose what you see. Or else it can affect your life. It can affect your emotion, your heart. Amen. For example, you are in your house. And your house is gulugulu. You know gulugulu? A place where you find anything. You ask any. Google pala yung Google. Gulugulu. You know, it's like a topsy-turvy. Everything is a mess. And you're... I cannot imagine a person can sleep in a bed full of mess. I cannot sleep in that kind of, you know, room. I need to fix everything before I can rest. Amen. That's our attitude with my wife. We cannot sleep until we fix everything. I have 5 kids. That's why 2 a.m. ang ano namin, ang, what's this? Average sleeping time. But I discipline my family from now. They don't have classes. So the kids don't have classes. So it's okay for them to sleep late at night. But I told them not at 2 a.m. Huh? Or 1 a.m. We need to sleep before 12. Because if you sleep before 12, you're already puyat. Amen? Amen? So, we need to have a vision. The greatest gift that one can receive from God. It's not money. Amen. It's vision. So, brothers and sisters, you are blessed if you have vision. If you don't have material things, you don't have a fancy clothes, but you have vision, someday you will have fancy clothes. If you don't have business or you don't have a lot of money, someday because you have a vision, you will have a lot of money. Amen. If you don't have a business, someday you will have a business if you have a vision. Because vision does not base on what you have right now. It's based on your bright, on the bright future of the Lord for your life. Amen. God has a vision for you. You must receive this vision. Now, okay? Amen? Answer the call, please. Your eyes can show you what? But vision shows you what could be. Amen. I will repeat. Your eyes can show you what? Tama ba ako? What is right now? No? But vision shows you what could be. In Tagalog, Nakikita mo lang yung mga mayroon ngayon. Pero yung vision nakikita mo, yung pwedeng magkaroon ka.
Amen.
In the future.
Amen.
Yung kayang gawin ng Diyos sa buhay mo. God can do a lot of things in your life if you will just allow Him. Amen. And you need to have vision for you to really, you know, accomplish it. To realize it in your life. Pastor, you know, Pastor, there's a dream in my heart. I think this is a godly vision. This is God's vision for me. Why? Because someday I want my life to be used by God. Although I am not I cannot see myself as a pastor, but I want someday God will use my life, my wealth, to be an instrument or on my assets will be used for the glory of God.
Amen.
That's a good vision. Diba? Yayaman ka, dadami ang ari-arian mo. And those properties, you will convert it into what? Mission, what's that? Mission area. Or all the missionaries will go there and you will feed them. Or you will have a bahay ampunan or a rehabilitation center. And it's free. Wow. Because you are so rich. But dahil mayamang-mayamang ka na, free na lang lahat ng mga ano doon, then you will have bahay ampunan. You will adopt a lot of kids. Why? Because you are so, so rich. So God can also, I think that's a good vision for your life. One of our vision with my wife is God will enrich us in the Philippines so that we can have a, you know, bahay ampunan. And this bahay ampunan, we will adopt a lot of kids and they will study free of charge until they reach college.
Amen.
Praise God. No? Ganda ng ganyan, no? So, something is, God is putting something in your heart. And if it's God's vision for you or God's dream for your life, it means that vision or that dream will contribute something for the good of humanity. Or, you know, or God can use you to become a politician someday. Amen? Diba? Baka mayroon dito, isang araw magiging prime minister. You'll become a prime minister of Canada. Maybe one of our kids. That's why, if they wake up, don't tell them, "Oh, you lazy kids, get up! It's already 2 p.m. No, don't tell them like that. Tell them, "Oh, get up, Senator! Get up, Mr. Prime Minister! Confess, prophesy to these kids. Huwag mong sasabihin ng mga pangit. Ang tamad mo talaga, mana ka sa kanino ka pa ba nagmana? Eh, sa'yo. Mana sa'yo yan, amen? Nandiyan pa ba tayo? So, please, fix your language, especially to your kids, because your kids, these people, God can use them in the end times. God has a purpose for their life. By the way, vision is your purpose in technicolor.
Ooh.
I love that. Your purpose in technicolor. You can see your purpose in life in a lot of ways, in many colors.
Amen.
That is called vision. Like this, no? You can see a lot of colors. I cannot even stare to these lights. Why? Because it's so colorful. It's so bright. Amen? Amen? From now on, use sunglasses every time. When you are in the church, use sunglasses. Somebody asks you, "Why are you still using sunglasses inside the church and it's so dark?" Tell them, "Because I have a bright future." Nakakasilaw kasi ang aking kinabukasan. Di ba? Amen? Pwede, no? Pwede, no? Are you still with me? Okay, so next. I'm trying to explain to you what is vision, okay? I hope you will get a meaning. You got to have faith in order to have vision, and you have to get vision and apply faith to make it into reality. Why? Because vision is like faith. Looking things that are not as yet they were. Romans 4:17 yun. Romans chapter 4 verse 17 says, Abraham looked at the things that are not as though they were. He believed that even though his wife is a barren woman, and yet because God told him that this is my vision to you. By the way, I will give you the full verses later on. No? Even though you are barren, you will become father of many nations. So he believed it in his heart. Amen? And it was accounted to him as righteousness. Why? Because of God's vision. He is being caught by the vision of the Lord for his life. Okay. Now, vision. Okay. What is the example of vision? Yeah, I told you already this verse in Jeremiah 29:11. Will you please read with me? For I know the thoughts that I think toward you. 1, 2, 3, go. For I know. So that's an example of vision. God gave this to Israelite people because, you know, they experienced a lot of bad things in their lives. And the reason why they experienced a lot of bad things is because they are so hard-headed. Instead of worshiping God, they worship idols. Instead of, being faithful to God, they turn away from God. So, you know, God removed his protection from them. And Babylonians captured them and brought them to Babylon and become exiles. They are prisoners. But God said through Jeremiah, even though you experience those things in life, God still has plans for you. God still has dreams for you. Good news, even though you have wasted your 40 years of your life before, or 20 years of your life before, or you have committed any mistakes in life, starting from now, if you will just be caught with this vision of God for your life, if you will just receive this dream of God for your life, you will have a bright future. Amen. Doesn't matter whatever you've done in the past. Amen. Even though you have committed, a grave sin in the past, God will forget it. He said, I know the plans that I have for you. I want you to walk in these plans. I want you to fulfill my purposes for your life. I want you to see the vision, my vision for your life, my thoughts for your life. Amen. And I don't want to harm you. The reason why you are harmed because you are not being caught with my vision for you. Just accept this vision. Receive it in your heart. Be caught with this vision. And your life will never be the same again. You will have a bright future. Amen. 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 How many of you here wants to start this bright future in your life? The moment I received this vision, I said to myself, I am the starting point of a blessed people in my generation. I am the start. Because my predecessors, pang tawag doon, yung mga descendants ko, pataas. They did not experience a blessed life. My grandfather has three wives. My dad has two wives. Praise God, I have one wife. Amen? Amen? That's my father's side. My mother's side, those are sickly people. My grandmother is sickly. But praise God for my grandmother because before she died, she received Christ as his Lord as her Lord and Savior. My mom died early. My uncle died early. Oh no, because of sickness. And I told myself, I am the start of a person who has a long life.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Kasi when my mom and my grandmother died. By the way, my grandmother is the one who brought raised me. I mean, not my mom, not my dad, but my grandma. She raised me and she told me before she died. She said, I don't have anything to offer to give to you as an inheritance. Only your education. So I study hard to finish my education and praise God as a civil engineer. Amen. I did nothing. I became a pastor. That's my own plan, to become a civil engineer, to become one of the wealthiest civil engineers in Rosales. In DPWH. Hallelujah. DPWH, no? Ang yayaman ng mga engineer doon. Why? Because my dream is to become rich. Why? Because I was so poor that I cooked the fish of bagoong because we don't have money, we don't have food. For lunch, for dinner, bagoong na pinirito, yung isda niya. Sarap nun, ha? Yung iba nga, nagdidildil lang ng asin, no? Salt and pepper. Wow, social. That's my food, Pastor. Salt and pepper with rice. Amen? Amen? Yung social, yung gatas, yung tinimpla pang gatas, lalagay sa kanin. Oh, tayo, kape lang, kape. Huh? Coffee and rice. Have you experienced that? Being poor, coffee and rice. Yeah, that's our food. And if there's no coffee and rice, you know, salt and pepper. Salt and pepper, like this. You know, pinapadamo pa dyan sa ano. Amen? That's how poor we are in the Philippines. And we have a lot of debts. Marami kaming utang. And that's why my dream is to become rich, to become one of the richest engineer in DPWH. High po sa mga DPWH. You know why and how this engineer became rich, okay, in DPWH. But that's my dream. Praise God. I did not end up to be a civil engineer. I end up to be what? To be a pastor. Praise God, I'm blessed. Amen. Because this is the higher calling for my life. Oh. You know, I question God, why is it that I burn all my kilay just to study, just to finish civil engineering. I study hard for this, but I ended up to be a pastor. And he said to me, anak, that's your dream. But that's not my dream for you. So why did you allow me to become a civil engineer? You should have pulled me out from my university and put me into a Bible school. Doesn't make sense. And God said, remember, John, everything in your life has a purpose. Everything that you went through is part of the great destiny for your life. I'm telling you, brothers and sisters, everything that you went through is part of the greater plan of God for your life. If not, if I not became an engineer, I will not go to Middle East to become an engineer there. But at the same time, to pastor a church. And I will not be here now if I did not become a civil engineer. For 2-3 years, I became a civil engineer in Dubai. Praise God for that. Amen? Praise God. So, for I know the thoughts that I think toward you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, thoughts to give you a future and a hope. That's the God that I know. Amen? Amen? The God that I know has a great plan, a great purpose for my life, a good plan, a good hope, a bright future.
Amen.
You better love this God. You better serve Him more. You better love, worship Him more. Why? Because this is the God that we have.
Amen.
Amen. Be faithful to this God.
Amen.
He holds your life. He has a bright future for you and for your family. And not only for your family, also for your posterity. What's posterity, Pastor? Your descendants. Your descendants will be mighty.
Amen.
In the land. Your descendants will be the richest, the strongest, the most, you know, influencer in the land. I have 5 kids. Praise God for these 5 kids. These are the gifts of God for my life.
Amen.
Amen? And being blessed started from my life.
Amen.
When I was caught with this vision. Next. Vision is what the Lord intended you to be and to do long before you were born.
Amen.
I'm telling you, before you were born, before your mom pushed you hard. No? Amen. To be born in this world. But before you were born, you are still a fetus. God already taught. God already has a plan for your life.
Amen.
And that plan is called vision.
Amen.
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 Vision is more than your dreams in life. Vision is more than your aspirations, your goals, and your, you know, what you want in this life. This is all about your assignment. Okay, to understand more, we have a long series. Okay, this is the first week of this series called Vision. We still have 3 weeks to study this vision, and to understand more, this first Sunday of our vision series. Let's go to Abram or Abraham. Before he was called Abraham, he was called Abram. The meaning of Abram is father, highly father. But God changed his name into Abraham. Amen? Because before he did not eat, he is not eating ham. He don't have ham. But because God blessed him, he became Abraham. Father of many nations. Okay. And this passage, particular passage that I will share to you, I'll just have, just give me 15 minutes. Tama ba ako? What time I started? 5? 5? Exact? 4:30? Yeah. Okay. Just give me 15 minutes more. Okay. This is the first time the Bible mentioned the word vision. There's a principle in here that we can learn. So what can vision do to your life? This passage or passages will help you. Amen? Will do something to you. This is called, you know, vision. Amen? Let's go to that verse. After these things, the word of the Lord came to Abram in a vision. Okay? In a vision. Saying, do not be afraid, Abram. I am your shield, your exceedingly great reward. Verse 2. But Abram said, Lord, God, what you will give me, saying, I go childless, and the heir of my house is Eliezer of Damascus. Then Abram said, look, you have given me no offspring. Indeed, one born in my house is my heir. And behold, the word of the Lord came to him saying, this one shall not be your heir, but one who will come from your own body shall be your heir. Verse 5, then he brought him outside and said, look now toward heaven and count the stars if you are able to number them. And he said to him, so shall your descendants be. And he believed in the Lord and he counted it to him for righteousness. What vision does to us? Vision, number one, removes fear in your heart.
Amen.
And what is that fear? The fear of the future. How many of you here has the fear of future? What if? What if? Diba? Especially, what if I die tomorrow? What will happen to my family? What if I have COVID Delta? What will happen to me? What if I don't have money to pay all my bills? Those are all our fears, right? And it became worries. Why? Because we always think about it. And it destroys our focus. It hinders our progress. We don't have progress. We don't have development in life. We don't grow. Why? Because of worry. Tandaan mo. Always remember, worry makes you, you know, a barren person. A person that cannot do anything. Why? Because it hinders your progress. So, fear also controls your life. Fear controls you. Amen. And Abraham's God said to him in a vision, verse 1. Let's go back to verse 1 and verse 2. Verse 1 and verse 2 ba to? After these things, the word of the Lord came to Abraham in a vision saying, do not be afraid, Abraham. I am your shield, your exceedingly great reward. God assured him that I'm about to show you something. I mean, are you ready for God to show you something? Because sometimes we settle on the things that we are experiencing right now. God needs to show us something so that our eyes will be open. Amen. Amen. And if our eyes are open, our fear will be demolished, will be destroyed. Fear is being removed if you have a vision from God. You have a bright future. You know, the fact that I've shared this to you, all your fears are being, you know, removed. Why? Because God holds your future. God holds your kids. You have a bright future. God don't want you to be sick, to be dead early at your age. Too gone too soon. What's that? Gone too soon. Diba? Yung your life is not like that. Amen. God wants to reward you with long life so that you can do a lot of things for Him. Your life is not yet enough. Your age is not yet enough. You are not yet full. Don't get out from this world without doing anything that is remarkable. Hello? God has still plans for your life. Amen. 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 Remove your fear. Remove your fear. That vision will remove that fear. God has a dream for your life. How many of you here? Are you already happy with your life? Or are you already fulfilled with your life? Maybe happy or, Pastor, I'm joyful. I'm happy. But I am not yet done. I still have a lot of things to do in life. How many of you here that says that? Amen. So God is not yet done. God is not finished with your life. Amen? Amen. 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 Don't fear. Because God has a great plan for your life. Amen. He's not yet done. Di pa siya tapos sa buhay mo. Remove all fears. Amen. The fear of future. What if, Pastor, what will happen to me after 10 years or after 5 years? What if, Pastor, we will go home because our visa expired. Amen. What will happen to us, Pastor, if we got COVID? You know, we are so much thinking of our future. But did you know that our future is in the hands of God? Amen. God knows all things. Amen. So entrust your life to God. Amen. Will you please entrust your life to God? Will you please say to God, Lord, I entrust my life to you. I'll just raise up my life to you, Lord. I'll just raise up my heart to you, God. Whatever you want me to do, Lord, I will do. Let your will be done. That's the prayer of Jesus Christ, right? Let your will be done and your kingdom come in me. Ganun dapat ang prayer natin, Lord, your will be done and your kingdom come. Will you please pray that? Gusto mo bang ikaw ay maging, your life will be fulfilled? Get this vision and all your fears. You know what's the fear of Abraham? He don't have kids. I don't have kids. By the way, Abraham is not the barren one, but his wife Sarah. You know Sarah? Sarah is a different wife. That's why his name, before God changed his name to Sarah, his name is Sarai. And you know the meaning of Sarai? All ladies will identify with Sarai. All wives here. Why? Because Sarai means sir. She is the leader of the family. Yeah, Sarai means sir. Sarai. Sire. Char in Russia. Char. You know, char means ruler. So, ang babae ang nagahari sa bahay. Si Abraham, sunod-sunuran lang. Abraham is just, you know, under desire. You know that word, under desire? Will you please translate it into English? What's under desire in English? It's like this, Sister Crystal. You are, Brother Paul is the lion, but you are the trainer. He's the lion, but you are the trainer of the lion. Amen? Amen? He is the head, but you are the neck. You control the head. Amen? So that's sire. That's why? Because when Abraham said, when Sarai said, what happened to the promise of God that he will give us a child? Nothing. Go and have sex with my katulong, with my servant named Hagar. Yes, dear. Yes, dear. So, Ishmaelites came out. And who is Ishmaelites? The Arab people. They are the dangerous people. And these people surrounded the country Israel. And they are, you know, throwing bombs to them until now. That's their enmity. That's their biggest problem. Why? Because of this, you know, weaknesses of Sarai. Sarai is the ruler. Sarai said, go and do this. And Abraham said, yes, ma'am. And God said, no, from now on, you're no longer Sarai. You will be called Sarah. It means you will become submissive to your husband. Amen? Amen. And every husband say, amen. Walang mag-amen mga husband, ha? Okay, vision removes fear. Number two, vision. What will vision do to us? Vision gets your eyes off from temporary things. Verse 3, look. Then Abraham said, look. Look at this word, look. This different look. Why? Because look, he is looking at the temporary things, at the present things. Nakatingin siya sa mga bagay-bagay sa paligid niya. Look, you've given me no offspring. Indeed, one born in my house is my heir. And behold, the word of the Lord came to him saying, this one shall not be your heir, but one who will come from your own body shall be your heir. So vision, listen, removes your eyes off from your temporary situation. You have problems right now? Vision will remove you from, you know, looking at your problems. Because sometimes, because of problems, it affects, you know, your emotion. It affects your decision. It affects your life. Wala kang pera, nakita mo yung, you saw your wallet, it has no money. Why? Because your money is in your card. Wow. A lot of money in the card. But when you check in the TD, your account does not have money. And you will become what? Crazy. Ah, I don't have money. What will happen to us? And you will fight your spouse because you don't have money. Amen? You are affected with these things. If you don't have, you know, me and my wife, if we don't have milk, we don't have pampers, diapers. Two kids are still using diapers. And all the shops are closed. There's no dede, there's no milk, and all the shops are closed. And I said to my wife, just have faith in God. Let's say that to your wife. Let's pray to the Lord. You don't have, go to any gasoline station. There is a shop there. Esso store. What's that? Esso. Basta mayroon doon. May gatas doon. Pampers wala. Pero may gatas doon. I drive 5 minutes away from my house. And I buy 3.25 homo milk. Even. And that solves our problem. Sometimes we are affected with this, you know, present situation of our life. We quarrel, we have high blood, mayroon tayong mga kung ano-anong mga disagreement, pagtatalo-talo. Why? It's because we base our situations with our emotions, reactions in our present circumstances. God said no. Don't be affected. If you have problems right now, don't be affected because God has a vision for you. Don't worry. Don't fear. God will solve your problems. God will help you. God said, do not look on the things that you have. Do not look on the things that you don't have. People who looks on the things that they don't have are the most miserable people. But people who looks at the things that they have, they are grateful. But people who looks at the things that they will have, these are visionaries. Amen. Amen. Wala ka pa? E titignan mo kahit wala pa, alam mong meron. Magkakaroon ka. Amen. It's called vision. Okay, last. Number 3, vision inspires you to look for bigger things. What did God told him? Verse 5. Then he brought him outside. He did this to Abram. And he said, look towards heaven. Look now toward heaven. And count the stars. If you can count them, if you are able to number them, he said to him, so shall your descendants be. It's like this. Abram! God, I don't have kids. You don't have kids? Come outside. You're always here in your tent. Before, they're still living in the tents. Tents. Tents lang yun. No? It's like our camping. In the middle of the night, ang lakas ng ulan, storm and winds came, and I call my neighbor. Lester, are you still awake? Yes, Pastor. What happened to your tent? Nothing, Pastor. What about you, Pastor? Are you okay? No, I'm not okay. My tent is about to be blew by these winds, strong winds. And then, okay, Pastor, if you want, just come over here in our tent. We are fit here. It's okay. Come and sleep here. And we carried all our small kids. And we wake them up. Kids, wake up. We are in the middle of the storm. Get up. And the kids said, what happened? We woke them up and we carried those two toddlers, brought them to the Lester's tent. It's like nothing is happening to the tent of Lester. It's not even moving. I'm gonna buy this kind of tent, amen. But until now, it's not sailed. So, you know, what happened to our tent? It broke. Yung pegs pala niya, all the pegs are what's that? Removed from the ground. So that's why our tent is about to, you know, babagsak. Amen. During the times of Abraham, they're just living in tents. Probably he's just staring at his wife. And his wife is like, what are you looking at? Why are you looking at me? Huh? 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 She's angry. Huh? 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 What do you think? What do you think of me? Huh? Yes, I'm barren, but tignan ko lang kung may uubra ka sa akin. Kahalit yung asawa, no? But God said, get out from that tent. I know you've been quarreling with your wife because she cannot bear you a child. Get out. And God showed him. In heaven, there's a lot of stars. Count those stars, Abram. Count their stars. And Abram started to count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. God naman, I cannot count this. It's a lot. And God said, that's your kids. Amen. Really? Yes. You're looking at the temporary things. You're looking at your problems. You are looking at your wife. She cannot bear you a child. Yes, I know she cannot bear you a child. But I'm about to give you a lot of descendants. Don't worry about those things that you know, are thinking and worrying about. Just have faith in me. Just be caught with this vision, because from you and from your descendants, all the nations will be blessed. That's my vision for you. That's my mission for your life. That's your purpose, to be a blessing, to be the father of many nations. Don't be sad. Don't be fearful. Don't be fearful of the future. Huwag kang matatakot. Huwag kang malulungkot. Don't be discouraged, Abram. Because I am your shield. I will protect you. I will be your exceeding and great reward. Amen. Amen. Can we clap our hands for God? So if you have problems right now, if you have difficulties right now, those are just temporary. Tell to your neighbor, temporary lang yan. That's just a temporary. Look at the larger picture. Amen. Amen. If you're lonely and your wife is lonely, try to date her under the moon. Go to the beach and start to look at the stars. These are the promises of God for us. Huh? Don't be sad. Don't be fearful. God has a lot of plans for us. God has a bright future for us and for our family. In fact, God will use us to be a blessing to other people. Amen. See yourself as a blessing to other people. Amen. Pastor, how can I be a blessing to other people if I myself, I am miserable right now? I have a lot of problems right now. Well, you're just looking at your present circumstances. But vision will help you to look at what God can do to your life. How many of you here wants to see what God can do to you? Amen. Do you want to see what God can do to you? Amen. Amen? Marami pang gayang gawin ng Diyos sa buhay mo. So, be caught with this vision. Start to have this vision. God, Lord, give me this vision. I know you have a dream for my life. Please reveal it to me. And I want to be caught with this vision. Will you please stand up? And let us pray. Thank you, God, for this wonderful time. I know this people has a bright future in them. They have a great potential in them. I know that you have stored a great future for their lives, for their families. And not only for their families, but Lord, your plan is to use them to become blessing to other people. That's the blessing of Abraham. The blessing of Abraham is God will bless you. And those who will curse you, will be cursed, but those who will bless you will be blessed. And you will be a blessing, not only to your own family, but to other people. From now on, commit your life to God, and He will use it. He will use it. God can use your life. You can make a difference, not only to your family, not only to your posterity, but to other people as well. You can be an influence. You can be a leader of leaders. Hallelujah. Lord, sometimes we are caught up with these small things, with these, you know, problems, God, in our house, in our family. We are caught up with these struggles, Lord. Mga problema namin. We were affected with all these problems, Lord. But we don't know that you have a greater plan for us. But right now, Lord, we have learned that you have a vision for us. We have learned that you have a great dream for us. And I pray and I declare that these people who have attended this service, Lord, will not only receive this vision, but will fulfill your dreams, your aspirations, your goals for their lives. Thank you so much, God. We receive these godly dreams. We receive this vision from you. We receive the bright future that you have prepared for us. We receive great things, Lord. And we will start to see the greater picture. We will begin to have, Lord, the perspective of God. Kapatid, have faith. Have faith. Your life is meant to be a life, a meaningful life. Your life is meant to fulfill the purposes of God. Your life is meant to be different. Your life is meant not to be just an ordinary, but to be an extraordinary kind of life. Receive it by faith in Jesus' mighty name. And the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine upon you and be gracious to you. And the Lord lift up His countenance to you and give you shalom peace. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Praise the Lord. And for those who have sickness and disease, Lord, I pray that this sickness will be totally healed today. Amen. Even our Sister Furley, who is suffering from, Lord, Lord, colds and headaches. And Lord, even our Sister Crystal, I know she's having some, Lord, difficulties in, I don't know, in her pregnancy or what. I don't know, God. But you are the God who is our healer. And we receive your healing today. And for all our relatives who are in the Philippines right now, to the mother of Pastora Rhea, I pray for complete healing. We extend this prayer to them, and we believe prayer is so powerful. And prayer is allowing you, God, to move in our behalf. Thank you so much for healing us. Thank you, Lord, for healing our relatives. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Shall we clap our hands for God? Praise the Lord. So, you can now be seated. Before we leave, our kids have a special number. Okay, so we have an announcement. Just wait for the venue and for the date. We will have our live class. Live class is with Encounter. So it's a retreat. Amen. It's a 3 days retreat. By the way, our brothers from Dubai is coming here this month. No, their arrival is this coming August 8th. Three families, one single lady and two families will arrive. So let us welcome them. August 8th is their arrival, but they're having a quarantine for 14 days because their vaccine is made in China. It should be Pfizer or Moderna. No, yun ang tanggap dito. 3 days lang ang 3 days lang ang quarantine. But because their vaccine is Sinovac, made in China, so they need to have a quarantine 14 days. And also, we're praying for one brother also with his family, and hopefully he will enter Canada before his start of his class. So let's pray for them, amen. And they will be with us here in the church. So August 22, they will attend the church, amen. And also, let us invite more. We still have a lot of empty chairs. So I hope follow up our sisters, ha? Yung mga wala ngayon, i-follow up po natin. Okay? So stand up and let's thank God for everything. God, salamat po. Thank you so much. And as we depart from this place, we receive the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the love of the Father and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. Lord, we will leave this place with peace, with the shalom peace. And as we, Lord God, have our eating fellowship, bless our food, cleanse it, sanctify it, in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord. Amen and amen. Amen.